I'll get up at 4-5 o'clock in the morning, grab all my gear. Sometimes I don't know where I'm going. Sometimes I'll drive and I'll think about it for a few minutes and then I'll just go. But you guys came at a perfect time because if I'm not doing a sunrise, I'm doing a sunset. So yeah, we're going up to Hodgson. It's just not too far. And I'm gonna hit up a back road. But this is what I'll do for on my days off, 1-2 days, whatever it may be. Usually in the mornings, I'll do this for quite some time. 3-4 hours. All depends on my mood and how well things are going. And how far I want to go. Right now, I feel like as much as I love art, my priority is to watch out for, you know, my son or my fiance. You know what I mean? I'm trying to remember here. Road. I think I remember this. And I'm losing the sunlight. There's a spot I wanted, damn it. We'll find it. Look at the sky in the field over there, and the pink. You see what I mean? Test out how well this camera works right here anyway. Certain things I memorize around here because I know the right time of the day. If I'm out, I'll know that the greenhouse off of Highland Avenue, the sunrise should be hitting off their windows right about now, and I think that would be a good time to go, kind of thing. You gotta pay attention to details like that if you're as particular as I am, because my fiance's spot working. She'll know who that is. As I get further into this photography thing, and as I take it more serious because of things that are happening, opportunities that seem to just be showing up, I'm getting more picky. I'm getting a lot more picky with things. So yeah, I take my time now, as opposed to before I would be happy with what I had, and I was just in it just to try to make a post, I guess. I was in it because in the beginning of the whole photography thing, I get addicted more to the Instagram thing than I did the whole taking photos. And then once I finally got myself a real camera, and it was just like something snapped in me, and now I could care less about the Instagram. I mean, I love sharing because there's other artists that I speak with on there, and it gives me these opportunities, but now it's just about, I don't know, it's like this is my meditation, I guess. This is, not only that, this is this is what I would love to do, to make a living doing, whether it's realistic or not. If I could make a comfortable living taking photos of it, especially of whatever I wanted, then yeah, I'd quit my job in a heartbeat if I had the right opportunity. And that's part of why I keep doing what I'm doing, because I'm convinced there's something and I could find something. Maybe I'm just a dreamer, I don't know. I hope not. You guys ready to come in? When I come across a photo that I want, it's urgent for me almost. It makes me feel confidence, or sometimes it makes me feel small. It freaks me out how big this world is and what happens in this world that we pass by every day, because our faces are shoved in our phone, or we're on our daily commute to work and we're just so blahed out of it that we don't really know what's going on around us. I feel I notice those moments, and I feel I can bring those out. Before of all this, I was addicted to opiates for, I went on like 9 years plus of abusing opiates. One hell of a ride. And then when I get off of them, I thought I was done. Started with my phone, relapsed, went another year, and now I basically consider it 3 years ago, because that's how long I've been sober. I wouldn't have found it without the abuse. I know I wouldn't have had the same passion. I used to quit a lot of things when I was younger. I gave up a lot, and I think it was, the timing was perfect. If I could quit drugs, quit heroin, fentanyl, heroin, and I think I could stick with just about anything else after that. And that's what drove me. That's what makes me who I am today, I guess. I mean, I don't want to base myself off of an addiction, but I wouldn't have found it without it. I don't think I would have. It was this feeling that I hadn't felt, I don't know, maybe ever. I felt like I was good at something. When I started it back with my phone, after my first relapse, I shared photos on Instagram, and I noticed this interaction, these reactions coming, so much of them with such little following. And I thought, wow, maybe I am good at something. And there were so many nice comments coming and messages coming my way that it gave me a feeling that I never had before. It was all just natural, I guess. I don't know how to explain it. It was funny. I'm all self-taught, you know. I've been inspired by many, but almost all my stuff is because of my mind, like my creative mind, not me trying to feed off of somebody else. Other artists inspire me, but this is my form of, expression, in a way. But it's not only that, it's my obsession. I found out, if I looked hard enough, I could find I hate to sound cliche, beauty in the most mundane things that you wouldn't expect. This geometry people don't pay attention to, that a lot of people, including myself, I never used to notice, with the buildings and rooftops and how they line up together. And It's interesting how much I notice now. A lot of my work that people like, I think, is awful.
I don't like a lot of it, you know? Not as much as they do. But I guess that's the whole part of it. I don't know. I feel like I'd be doing something wrong if I was just instantly satisfied with everything I took. Once I got a camera, it wasn't long into it, and I started liking my work. I say it's terrible. I'm being dramatic. I can always see ways to improve, but when I got that camera, it was just, there was something that I seen different in it, I guess, in the final product, you know. And then film is just a different beast of its own, I guess. Film gives you a different quality when it's all said and done. That grain says something. If I were to add grain to a digital photo, I feel like that's fake. I want a grainy photo from a real film photo kind of thing. And then I just have an appreciation for these older, the mechanics of these cameras and what you can do without a battery and just a lens and the right light and the right shutter speed. You know, it's incredible. And, you know, I have cameras that are from the 70s that would outlive some of these digital cameras today, you know. I did this one with film, with my Nikon F3 of my son, Asher. There's something that you won't get with a digital picture. I mean, I don't know if you feel any type of emotion when you look at that, but from digital, it's like I don't get that same type of feeling. It's so hard for me to put into words. I'm always looking, and I like that sometimes, and other times it's a pain, it drives me nuts, because I'll notice it'll be some of the best days and the best situations are when I'm in a truck with my coworkers headed to work instead of me doing what I really love to do. Danica already knows my fiance. She'll see the sunset and I'll be like, wow, that's an awesome sunset. She said, well, why don't you go out real quick? Because I already know what you want. And then, so I insinuate and I get my way and I go take some photos. I don't take too long. And then come back.